Hello everyone, we're here with Neil, Adah and Naman, who are having an extremely busy Diwali. Naman, it's your debut film, foraying into a thriller. You know, usually people start off with something more like a romantic comedy. So why this project?
I would always say a thriller. I think for us, the genre runs in our blood. Because for me, he's 10 years older than me. When I was still, I think, 14, 15, he had already started with Johnny Gaddar and then back-to-back thrillers. So for me, the most education I got about filmmaking was about thrillers. Then I started assisting. I assisted on Race 2, which was again a thriller by Abbas Mastan. They are the godfathers of this genre. So for us, it feels like home. So there was no other option.
All right. You are playing a character who's also partially on a wheelchair. What was the prep like? Was it really difficult?
Oh God. I mean, to be very honest, I think every film that I take up is a challenge, of course, in many ways. But this one definitely tops the list. As far as the wheelchair itself is concerned, you know, it was quite the task. I had to maneuver that wheelchair through the day, and it's an action film, it's a whodunit, it's a murder mystery, it's a mentally, yes, of course, physically even more challenging, because we are not doing a round of maybe about 4 to 5 kilometers just once. We are doing it through the day, almost about 15, 18 hours of non-stop, constant pushing yourself.
Right.
You know, I gained weight for the film because he wanted me to have a certain worn out look, you know, especially after from Saho. Mm-hmm. I was quite bulked up as muscled for the film there. But then I had to strip down all of that because he wanted me to look the character who's met with an accident, come back home. That was one thing. But more than that, I think, was when I had to get on the floor. Mm-hmm. Getting onto the floor and then pushing the body only with the forearms was very, very difficult.
Right.
It's like doing burpees constantly.
And you also don't want to overdo it, and maybe, you know, there's always this slight chance of offending someone who is physically
exactly,
disabled and
exactly.
exaggerating
To be
it.
Very honest, thank you for pointing that out. So I wanted to keep it very subtle. I haven't glorified the situation as much as I've glorified the plot. So even in our performances, I wanted to keep it very subtle, very nuanced, you know, very etched moments in the film. You will find out and when you see the film is when Vikram's character goes out there and he starts experiencing his own you know, kind of issues because of his disability.
Right. Adah, what about you? Tell us a little bit about your character and what it was like working in a murder mystery.
Yeah.
Is that always happening when you're on set?
Yes. But no, I can't tell you much about the character, of course, because it is a murder mystery. I'd be giving away too much. But since he spoke of the wheelchair thing, I'll tell you something more of the wheelchair thing. We had a song where I had to sit. Something that, yeah, all the girls out there would be interested, because every time you wear a gown, you want to stand up straight and it's, you have a high slit on a gown with like really high heels. Yeah. I had to sit on his lap on one knee whilst he was on the wheelchair and we had to do turns with it.
Yeah, we
he's
were maneuvering
so good.
Around
yeah,
the
he's so good at
wheelchair.
The wheelchair
so an
thing.
An entire song is composed of
yeah,
that.
He it's, needs it's to, yeah, he needs to get an award just for that. I mean, you've seen heroes doing action on fast bikes, on cars, on helicopters and what other, I think this is the first time you'll be seeing a hero doing action on a wheelchair. And then have the heroine perched on his lap while doing a 360
turn. But that song's
turn,
coming out
yeah.
very soon. It's
yeah,
beautiful.
That's one of my
very, very nice song. It's gorgeous. A song.
You guys also recreated Sogaya Yeh Jahan, which has so much family lineage also in it. So tell us a bit about the song.
We wanted to make it a completely new song rather than just have your run-of-the-mill remake of the original. So I think it's done beautifully, and Jubin has, you know, rendered it so well. And plus, it's a cult song. You can't take Sogaya away from Nitin Mukesh, and you
the
can't
scale
take
was
Nitin
very
Mukesh
different
away
also.
From Sogaya. Like he's saying, the scale, the tempo, everything, we had to give it a 2019 feel.
Yeah.
But he was up to it, and I think he's done a fab job again.
Right. Okay, guys, tell me, how different or not different is it when you're working with your sibling?
Well, for me, I never changed my equation on set with him. I never tried to be the boss, though he gave me that respect and he gave me that, you know, position. But for me, I'm in general, whoever knows me for how many ever years they know me, they know that I'm very emotional and very impulsive and instinctive person, you know. Even with Naman, I think the creative approach was more, you know, my strategy with him. And I just let myself loose as a brother. So I let him flow with his emotions. Mm-hmm. I let our, creativity kind of get to each other.
Okay, so when you were writing, you're of course also producing the film and you're writing the film, and there's so much abundance of content nowadays with the digital boom.
Of course, yeah.
Was that something that you kept in mind?
Thinking,
because content online is not censored. It's also a lot more detailed.
So it wasn't particular only for the online portal. It was, of course, keeping in mind a theatrical release, which is...
Right.
Which
yeah,
it
because
is,
it was supposed
for.
To have a theatrical
yes,
release.
Of
but
course.
Was it something because the competition is so stiff?
No,
because
so the idea of writing the content out was keeping in mind what the platforms would be offering to the end viewer, in their home. So it made life easier for us to make sure that, okay, they don't need to get educated about the genre.
Right.
Because before that, if I spoke of home invasion, I'd really have to dig into an archive and probably pull out a film for them to really relate to. And now, maybe not. Because in Hindi films, we don't see too many home invasion or murder mystery films. We see them, we can literally count in the last 10 years how many murder mystery films have come. And that's sad because the genre is very popular. Also, I feel that thrillers has so many other aspects into it, and there are subdivisions of thrillers.
Right.
There's home invasion is one of them. There's horror thriller. There's so many of them. So I think we wanted to...
So this is a niche in itself.
It is. And we wanted to make sure that in a thriller, we get into a home invasion. But keeping in mind the audience, like you said.
All right. Thank you so much, guys.
Thank you.
For joining us today.